Hello there, everybody. Welcome to yet another episode of Paradigm Shift in Educational Comedy. And I'm Dave, and this is Rich. Those of you who've watched our, you know, our stuff, you already know who we are. But there's, one or two others who may or may not pop up this chat. Kind of depends. Not sure yet. They have the join link, so if they're available, they will. If not, maybe next time. But this episode is titled, It's a Deviant Fart and You're Not Excused. And we're going to be discussing DeviantArt's biggest epic fail yet, the foolish premium price raises that come as a package deal with a side order of patronizing arrogance. And I'm going to go into screen capture mode so that we can show you what we mean. Okay. There's the lovely little Google window of infinite screenage there. Okay, we'll start with my main journal on it. I learned more with Deviant Core. Seeing as I don't function well under pressure, to take the heat off my ass about Common Core, I'm pleased to present to you something new to bitch about, Deviant Core. I finally saved up enough to buy, and it's gone. Look, I'm not the only one who realizes that DeviantArt has gone full-blown retard. Never go full-blown retard. I don't support Core. Then here's some other journals about it. No one is going to buy a Core membership because of the large price increase. I guarantee it. Everybody loves Core, or not. And these are like DeviantArt groups that have actually been started up in protest of this stupidity. There's even a wearechange.org petition. Like, this group here already has almost 900 members. Okay, you just muted, that's all that was. This group here already has almost 900 members. That one has over 400. And so on and so on. Great news, guys! I'm going to buy your house for 3 times less than what it's worth and sell you a house that's only half as good as your current one for almost twice the value of your current house. I call it my new core deal. And I credited the people for the memes and stuff that I use. Good morning, sir. Would you like to buy a core membership? What happened to premium membership? It's called Core now. You get the same features as premium, but pay more for it. No. And of course, there's been a bunch of comments. The last mem said it all. God, mem, meme, whatever. Thanks for putting my meme on here. So on and so on. And the first epic fail that they did, I did a journal on before called Boldly Facing Poop, and it's when they basically swapped out the original DeviantArt logo for the piece of Third Reich fucking shit that we see up here. Bleed and breed, the new master race for the Fuhrer. After reading the DeviantArt journal entry titled Boldly Facing the Future, my reply to it was, the explanation about the whole thing reads like something out of Brave New World, and the logo looks like a behind-the-scenes novelty piece where we finally get to see what was actually used by the children when they referred to the game Hunt the Zipper. No disrespect intended or anything. Love the music on the YouTube video, though. a whole lot of words that simply read to me as, take your soma, that's all the justification we need, we are the Borg. Freedom is irrelevant, constitution is irrelevant, your culture will adapt to service us, surrender your weapons, resistance is futile. There's a little Hitler fella thing. Then they did their video here. Here is their video that is basically badass music to send you into a hypnotic trance, the same sort of psychological marketing used when TV commercials insist and affirm over and over that Diet Coke, strike through elephant vomit, supposedly tastes awesome and wonderful. DeviantArt is one of the best sites on the internet, period. However, it is not because of its near useless help desk system. It's not because of its inefficiently maintained print service. It's not because of its utter disinterest in maintaining community integrity. And it's not because they become so mainstream that even YouTube acknowledges them as being a major social media site. It's because it's the best because it has a really awesome pre-established art community. It's the people that make it awesome, not the site itself and not the administrative staff. Without us, DeviantArt would be nothing. Granted, DeviantArt does have its intellectual fascists, cocks, trolls, and other troublemakers as well, but welcome to Earth. That is true for anywhere. The DeviantArt stands for deviated art. To not conform, but rather to explore new realms of ideas and expression. In my opinion, acting as if a pre-established symbol is your own original idea that supposedly took a year to think up is unparalleled ridiculousness. So I guess the new mantra to go with the new logo is, when all else fails, you can just rip off the Russians. The process of getting that core, oh, here's that freaking word core again, even well in advance. Process of getting that core story down on paper took almost a year. The result is bleed and breed art. This is our center of gravity and our reason for getting out of bed in the morning. Adolf Feller. And of course, here's a variation of that Nazi symbol used on a Russian site. Then got Putin here saying, bitch, please. You dare doubt Adolf Feller? Everything DeviantArt says is true and wholesome and correct, like American primetime TV and Mom's apple pie. The help in FAQ were written by God, so shut up, Putin, because you're stupid. To further elaborate on the disgustingness of the situation, General Tate and I have made our own YouTube video about the new logo. Enjoy, and, you know, you all can watch that later. I'm only starting off with this journal to provide some frame of reference, because this was the first major fuck-up that they did. And, you know, of course, the next one's even worse. You may download and re-upload this video freely. Here's the DA film version. Don't get the Brave New World references. Watch the movie online for free. So here's that embedded, so on and so on. Now, this journal is really good the way they outline the problem here. This one's by Panther PL, which I do believe PL stands for Poland. Rich, how well are you able to read this on the screen share?
I'm able to read it good.
Okay, well, you can narrate then, and I'll just scroll through.
Okay.
Gives me an opportunity to shut up for a little bit.
Put it in my... Well, I have to go back to the journal so I can read it in the Hangout. Okay. And of course, we start out with the SpongeBob, you know, meme here of pretty much what is DA is going through. It's essentially kind of imploding on itself, you know. It's almost like watching a hydrogen-filled blimp just basically explode, you know. It's just like one cell of hydrogen ignites and it goes wham and it blows up and, you know, destroys one part, and, you know, those flames are slowly, you know, bursting and coming towards you. That's kind of what DA is doing right now. But anyway, that meme says it all. So let's move on down. So I think everyone knows about the thing by now. It exploded so enormously fast. Well, there we go, exploded. When suddenly people refreshed their notification pages and got lasered in the eyes with these vivid, fudgily orange, and then some little link there, stolen symbols by their friends, usernames who had premium an hour. An hour later, someone discovered that the prices were almost doubled by then. The flaming shitstorm was impossible to stop. So what has Core done? Raised the price 3 months pre... And what are you doing?
I was trying to go to the link to where, you know, he said that something was stolen. It's a stash link. I'm trying to go to what they are referencing.
Oh, here we go.
Yeah. Look, Max Stanton. And it's that exact same. If you see the little star, and then you see the little star there. Basically, what they're saying is that star was artwork that somebody else did and that they stole. Someone else in a reply to one of my things about this also had mentioned that the font that DeviantArt used was a font stolen from the Fast and Furious movie series. And Shannon is playing here. Let's see here. Okie dokie, I may go take a look at DeviantArt since it's the subject of it, because I didn't even notice they changed their premium membership prices. Okay. She's been busy. It's all good. But yeah, so that thing that he linked to there just kind of, you know, establishes that DeviantArt acts like they're all about originality, but first for their freaking logo, they completely rip off a freaking, you know, neo-Nazi symbolism there. And, you know, someone told me that they ripped off the font from the Fast and Furious movies, and now even that little fucking star thingy was ripped off from somebody else.
Mm-hmm. Anyway.
Moving on.
So what has Core done? And this is the part that outrages me the most. Raised the price of a 3-month premium membership from $8 to $15, which is an 87.5% increase, rough estimation. Number two, the 12-month premium membership went from $30, $29.99, to $50, which is a 66% increase. Will simultaneously remove the 1 month until hell freezes over 7 years options, and replace the beloved dark green premium star with an orange Dragon Ball piece of shit that glitches out, and it's a badge that doesn't even fit with the site. Yeah.
Let's see what this is.
You can do that in a minute. I'm about to kind of expound here before we go into that new tab. Or not. Anyway, they're basically saying thank you for 15 years of hardcore support from all of you. Fuck you. Now we're going to take away some of your options. Go to hell. We don't care. You know, if you don't, you know, and number one, it has nothing to, the new icon has nothing to do with visibility. The old icons, in my opinion, the green ones that they went to, I think were an upgrade that was much needed. You just kind of go over it and it automatically pops up the window. You know, you click on it and it says, you know, what does this mean? And, you know, it shows you the whole thing, you know. And there was no need for them to go to this orange star. It's just a disgusting pile of shit that they took from, you know, that they took from something else that they never gave credit to. You know, yet again, the DA staff has their heads so far up their ass that, you know, it's disgusting. It's just merely disgusting. You know, thank you for 15 years. Now, fuck you. We're taking away some of your options. You're not allowed to, you know, at least try a premium membership for a month, you know, for like $2. Now you have to deal with a 3 month or a year, and that's the only option you get. You're not allowed to do anything else. Fuck you. And I mean, for most people, a 12-month premium membership was hard to afford to begin with, you know, a $30 membership, and, you know, around Christmas time.
Hey, 30 was fair, even though economically inconvenient. 30 was fair. 50 is ridiculous.
Yeah, 50 is like pushing where supergroups are. I mean, I paid $69.97 for my supergroup, and, you know, now it's just, you know, now they're pushing yearly memberships up to, like, you know, $50, and, you know, we get this piece of shit logo here that you can see up in front of you. You know, it's like glitching out to one side. You know, the white background isn't even really there. Oh, somebody's knocking at the door. I shall be right back.
Alrighty. But, yeah, this is just completely freaking ridiculous. And eliminating the, you know, the 1 month test drive is completely stupid, completely retarded. And I mean, you know, I always used to think that they should add a 6 month, you know, have 1 month, 3 months, 6 months, 12 months. You know, they would never add a 6 month. And now, you know, you only have two options, and they take and just jack the shit out of it. And on their original journal that DeviantArt did about it, they were extremely patronizing and like, you know, it's even worth five a month. It's even worth more than that. And we're just God, and yeah, and we're talking all like we're just doing the best for you, and we're just acting as if you're gonna believe it because we're saying it, so it's the truth, and you we know you're just gonna just bow to us and believe it, and you know, acting it's doublespeak, it's freaking Orwellian doublespeak, and you know, it's patronizing. It's basically making the assumption that all of DeviantArt's users are idiots, and that if they are simply told, oh, this is good for you, you're gonna love it, that, you know, we're just, you know, expected to, you know, hop on board with that. You know, they think we're that stupid. You know, just like my analogy earlier in the other journal about, you know, like what they do with the Diet Coke commercials. They're like, oh yeah, it's so nummy, yummy, and tasty and great. And it tastes like elephant shit. So yeah. It's just insult added to injury, added to more insult, added to more injury. And, you know, the help desk hasn't been all that helpful with much of anything in a long time. DeviantArt basically does not pay any attention to any of the feedback from the community. Most of the things that the community wants, DeviantArt just ignores. And all the stuff that the community doesn't want is what DeviantArt seems to want to actually implement. And they act as if we all want it and love it, even though everybody's just screaming, no, do not do this, do not do that, bad idea, let's not go there. But they just completely ignore the community, like, oh, what's good for us should be good for you, and you will eat it up, and you will like it, because we are the DA Reich. So says Adolf Fella. Rich, are you back yet? Apparently not. Okay, so Rich was narrating this, and I'm just kind of trying to fill space and time with dialogue here while waiting for Richard to return, which I'm sure he will any moment now here. But yeah, I guess we can kind of look at this. Messed up logos. So we could see how not only is the new logo a complete and total ripoff of something else, but they can't even manage to implement it properly. It just does all kinds of fucking up. And then, of course, there was this. To where the star thing obviously is ripped off from some other site somewhere else. So we got star pro user and the same star core member. And I remember where somebody mentioned that now. One thing I wasn't sure, but it just clicked in. It was a comment on this one. Scroll down right quick. Excuse me, it's been kind of a sleepy day. One day's worth of sleep within a 2-day period. By that I mean the amount of sleep required for, you know, and so I'm kind of half in, half out with that. And then of course it's rainy and so on, and yeah, my head's all messed up today, but that's okay. And it was Skater Eye. I don't know if that's how they pronounce it, but Skater Eye said, "Look at the new font that goes with the new logo. It was taken from Need for Speed Most Wanted." And I then replied with, "They bleed and breed their Need for Speed as it is what they are most wanting. LOL." But yeah, so that's where I found out about the font ripping off was from Skater Eye. So
by the way, I am back. What's up? Turn.
Yeah, so we can continue where we left off. Then I was just kind of filling up time in conversation.
Well, from my personal experience, going past where I was complaining and bitching about the premiums, didn't change the benefits, didn't add any at all. That is true. Yeah, I did notice, I don't know how many other users have probably noticed, but they did get rid of the webcam feature that you used to be able to put on your profile, and they fucked that whole thing up. So now if you want a really properly sized image on your profile page, I've learned that you have to use your DeviantID as, you know, kind of your main slot for all that stuff, because for whatever reason the DeviantID displays properly, but if you try to use it in a text box, it just fucks up and it doesn't do what it's supposed to. It just like makes a super small image that you can't even hardly see, and it just looks really stupid. So if you're trying to put a large embedded image on your page, you're gonna have to use your dev ID, which that's what I eventually figured out I had to do, because the the widget that they have now is just a normal text box widget, you know, where you can put whatever you feel like on there. And that thing doesn't really work for images for whatever reason. It bugs out and it makes a super tiny little image that you can't expand to the borders of the box. So for whatever reason, that I've noticed has gotten removed. I haven't noticed anything else really get removed. I haven't noticed anything that I haven't seen them take anything away. Besides, like, you know, obviously, they've gotten rid of, you know, the memberships, but I haven't seen them take anything away as of recently. The only thing I've really noticed is, like, they got rid of Deviant gear, which was a huge mistake. That was a big line of their income. Then they decide to, you know, not update anything else with their print service, which I haven't really used, but I've heard they haven't updated it at all, and it sucks, and it doesn't work right. So yeah, basically, DA is unfortunately run by a staff of inept fucktards who really don't know anything, and they're finally getting the huge backlash that they have coming to them. You know, like Y2 cunt and, you know, all those people. And if you're watching, shame on you. You know, we tell you to help us, and what do? You get all pissed off and butthurt that we're right, and you're full of shit and can't fucking see it. You know, it's just, it's unfortunate that DA has turned into such a, you know, backwash run by morons, and, you know, there's no real artistic direction or scope anymore. When I joined DA, you know, 5 years ago now, almost. Can't believe it's been 5 years.
You know, I've noticed that, and other people have had other experiences that might contradict this. I can't speak for everybody in all experiences, but from what I've seen, a lot of the times when you have really genuine, you know, troublemakers and trolls and abusers, and I'm not just talking about like people being mean or whatever. I mean, if someone's going to be mean, that's their problem, and that's their right to freedom of speech and whatever. I'm talking about the stalking, harassing, really creeping, troublemaking, nasty sort of people. DeviantArt won't do anything about it. They'll, even though it's against their, you know, their community guidelines and all that, they won't do shit about it at all. But if someone posts a journal that has a political or whatever opinion that the staff at DeviantArt feels goes against their political views, and if, you know, that for whatever reason they happen to find, you know, to come across it and find that it's inappropriate or whatever per their views, not inappropriate to community guidelines, not causing trouble or whatever, but it's like, oh, that person doesn't agree with us politically, so, you know, we're gonna ban them and whatever. And there's been a lot of occurrences of, you know, of that sort of thing going on.
I said it's
a miracle that I haven't been banned yet, because I mean, anybody who knows my art and has seen that, I am about as politically incorrect as they come. So,
well, yeah, and especially me, because I've posted lots of journals that are pretty far out there, you know, in terms of political views. But yeah, I guess another thing I could bring up on that front is there was the Conquerors who ran a group called Counter Jihad. You know, and he was against extremist Muslims and all that stuff, and I'm against extremists of any religion, you know, who want to trample others' rights and, you know, cause problems. But, you know, and then there was, what was the other guy's name? It's on my profile somewhere. Here we go. Let me take a look here. He just recently got banned for whatever reason, but his account name is 345RV5, and who knows, given his icon that looks similar to the Conquerors, he might have been the Conquerors, but yet again, there's obviously a staff member somewhere that doesn't like what they think or what they say, and that's totally counterintuitive. to, you know, their policies. I mean, you know, DA is supposed to be an open-minded place where ideas can be discussed and explored and, you know, agreed upon. Now, I will
be
say
a, be a deviating deviant as long as you are conforming to the ideologies of the DA staff.
But anyway, and apparently, you know, the Conquerors, and I don't know so much about the Conquerors or RV5, 345, but, you know, they seem to have friends of all different political spectrums. I mean, communists, you know, guys like me who aren't communists, even though there might be some ignorant, dumb fucks out there like, well, certain unmentionable people who think I'm a communist hick who really don't know me that well, but, you know, their name is to not be discussed.
You can just go ahead and say Crimson Flake.
Eh, I don't feel the need to mention his name. He's not worthy of me saying anything. But, anyway, you know, I'm friends with some of these guys too, and I respect their right to an opinion. You know, they want to think communist thoughts. You know, that's their deal. You know, there's no sin against humanity if you do. I mean, you know, it takes all types to make a planet go around. But anyway, you know, yeah, I mean, it's like, it's just kind of bullshit, you know. There's, and then there's other people around on DA called, there was this one person that couple of these guys came to me on, or, well, actually, no, I happened to see one of their images in the controversy group. And essentially what happened was, I think it was Sudi Jared was the person's name, but anyway, she or he or whoever posted something that was really arrogantly stupid. It was like one of those, like, you know, Islam is always right type things, you know, fuck the USA, fuck this, fuck that, you know, really derogatory, stupid, you know, one-sided, kind of Naziistic type spielings, you know, basically calling somebody of another persuasion a hate group, or, you know, and I just politely, without saying anything, I was just like, no, they're not really hate groups, they're just, you know, people with other opinions who, you know, are voicing their side on something, and they have genuine concerns, and, or they've got a constitutional right to do that. She or he couldn't comment back, couldn't say anything to anything that I said, couldn't argue a single case as to how I was wrong. And, you know, so, I mean, DA'll put up with that kind of crap. You know, they'll allow, you know, people like that to go around saying, you know, being complete asshats to everybody that disagrees with them. But yet, if you have a difference in opinion on something, they just kind of nuke your account and say, well, fuck you, we don't like you because you don't believe as we do. But yet, they'll allow little extremist trolls to run around, you know, causing problems for other people and, you know, creating division and argument, which I'm pretty sure is against DA's rules. So, I mean, yet again, DA is not perfect. The staff aren't a bunch of androids. I'm sure there's probably good staff members out there that are trying to do something, that know that there's something wrong that needs to be solved and taken care of, you know. And it's kind of like, unfortunately, for in their case, I imagine it's probably like a lot of the minority of good people in the U.S. Congress. They're basically fighting a tsunami wave with a tin bucket, essentially. You know, there's not, all they can really do is say no to something or have a filibuster, but they can't really, there's nothing they can do because the overall system is so rigged that there's no way that they can, you know, they can change anything until, you know, something big happens. But anyway, I mean, I think, you know, everybody has a right to a view on DA or really anywhere, even if it's totally obscene and offensive. I think people have a right to say what they feel and what they genuinely want to spew, you know. just as long as they also have in mind that there are other people of the exact opposite persuasion that will be just as offensive and lewd to them as they are to the other person. As long I'm fine with people's opinions, as long as people are respectful of each other's opinions and not total dickwads about it and walking around like Adolf Hitler saying, no, it's my opinion or you're going to the gulag kind of attitude. I'm very easygoing with other people, you know, when it comes to their political views or their philosophical views or whatever, mind you, their ideologies, you know. Like I said, it takes all types to make a world, but, you know, it just is what it is, you know. Shit's shit, people are people, but unfortunately on DA's part, they're not making it any, they're not making it better, they're not making it any easier, they're not doing a good job. But I guess I should start reading the journal some more. One, DA needs to make money, but the way they executed this change probably made them earn less money than before. Well, yes, economically speaking, especially in this shitty economy, raising prices in a bad economy to begin with isn't going to do your business any good. That's just going to turn people off to your product. You know, see, if they had done like maybe a 15-year anniversary special where they made premium memberships go down to like, say, like $15.99 or something like that, like a special anniversary price for 12 months. I mean, that would have been the smart thing to do, and lower the 7-year thing down to like $30 for the time being, you know, just to celebrate and say, you know, thank you for 15 years of continued support.
Or no, just have a saying to where that the 7-year, you know, hell freezing over thing is like $99.95 or something. You know, like do that. Because how much was it before? Something like $199 or $245 or whatever the fuck it was.
It was like $199, I think.
Yeah.
Which are super expensive. I mean, my God.
Yeah, so I mean, to have it for like, you know, $99.95 on an anniversary deal, like, you know, even I would have like grabbed that.
Yeah, I would have taken advantage of that offer.
Yeah, I mean, totally.
That's like 7 years of like pure premium membership, and you don't have to worry about it. And
yeah,
you know, bring out the buy one get one free. You know, buy one of those for somebody else for the 15-year anniversary. And you get one. Make the Christmas special like two times this year. They would make so much money, but no.
Oh, no kidding. No. They would they would make like millions of dollars almost overnight if they did that. It would be fucking raining money.
That would have been the smart thing to do. Get rid of this core garbage, cut it out.
They could have filled a swimming pool with $100 bills if they did that.
Yeah. People would have looked at that and said, oh, yeah, start throwing money at them. But no, we gotta piss everybody off. We got to raise the premiums, you know. Welcome to the new healthcare marketplace. You get less for more. It's that same type of shit. But anyway, I'm going to go into detail here on this journal. Look, we all understand that DeviantArt Incorporated is a big corporation, and they need to make a lot of money in order to sustain their business. However, their business tactics are some of the dumbest I've ever seen, and me being an amateur economist, I agree with that statement. What happened? They raised the price overnight without telling us by a large amount, almost doubling it. Plus $7 for 3 months, 87.5% increase, plus $20 a year, 66% increase without adding any features, without adding anything cool. What would have been awesome is they could have said, hey, we're going to, and for the 15th anniversary, we're going to reboot Deviant Gear, clean up the commission system and make sure the prints thing is better than ever, and we're going to make DA Film like something that we release for like a, you know, you can give one, all premium members will receive, who have been on the site for 5 years or more, will receive a Deviant film as a special gift from DeviantArt, you know, and you will be able to give a Deviant film subscription to a member once every year, or even twice every year, like once every 6 months. They could do that. They would get so many people joining the site over that, it wouldn't even be funny, you know, and increase, like, you know, maximum film times to like 30 minutes instead of, you know, like whatever it is, 15, you know, double the film time. So that way you can, you know, upload larger.
I have DA film, so I can speak to that. The limit is, 200 megs and, 20 minutes.
20 minutes. Okay.
Yeah. I really think they should, if they want to conserve space, they should make the limit like 350 megs, no time limit. Because if their main concern is storage space, then, you know, just put a cap on that and don't be a dick about the time. That would be my opinion.
Yeah, and having a film that's bigger than that is probably pretty rare. Well, maybe not. I mean, a full feature-length movie would probably go over that easily, but, you know, I mean, there are a lot of things that you could upload under 350 megs, but anyway, I mean, you know, those are some of the creative things that I can think of, and I'm not even a moderator that would, you know, bring so much money into the site. It's not even funny. You'd have people throwing $100 bills at you, you know, but instead they do this bullshit. They make this vomit, monkey puke, green little Nazi swastika in the corner, and then they throw the I Learned Less with Common Core bullshit logo next to, you know, next to our account names. It's like, come on, guys. You guys have absolutely no respect for anybody. You guys are just in it for yourselves. You're arrogant little greedy pigs. Oink, 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 oink. Snort. Give us your money. I mean, that's just BS. But anyway, moving on. And essentially, yeah. How do they expect low and middle class people, students included, to afford this, which make up 90% of the community? What about the hundreds or even thousands of people who say, I was about to buy myself a year-long premium membership because I finally saved up enough funds, but now the price. Now, after the price spike, I can't frickin' afford it, you know. I mean, yeah, it's $50. $50, a lot of us, you know, who are in middle class, you know, can at least maybe afford that once a year. But there are a lot of people out there, you know, who are literally maybe dormed up with three other people who are earning $9 an hour and trying to, you know, keep an apartment and, like, keep the basics in the fridge and stuff. $50 is a lot of money. I mean, that's like a couple of tanks of gas, you know. If nobody's going to be able to afford that, you know. So, you know, DA's being fucking retarded. You know, it just goes to show how out of touch the admins are, you know. And if they want to ban me for saying that, they can go right ahead. They're just losing somebody who meant something to the community. And, you know, that'll be a shame, but overall, it's just going to backfire on them more. The more people speak up, and the more they try to crack down on varying.
Well, if they ban you, they'd have to ban what, the 12,000 people or so that signed that one WeAreChange.org petition. That's going to quickly go up to 15,000 to finalize, and then there's probably a lot more than that who are speaking out. So, what are they going to do? Like ban more than a third of their fucking user base? They're not going to ban anybody for saying that, because there's so many people saying that they need to ban like a minimum of one third their site.
Yeah, it is true, but I mean, we've seen DA be this stupid. It wouldn't pass me. It wouldn't put me against them to be even stupider and try that bullshit. I mean, especially with Y2Gen. Had her head up her ass. She couldn't even think straight. But anyway, you're losing a significant amount of income on those people who've been saving up for a while and didn't buy the membership whilst it was still relatively cheap, not to mention they gave up on saving funds further after that dick move. DA prices go up, income goes down. You can't explain that. Using Bill O'Reilly, that's kind of funny. The core members are often ashamed of their status and many want to cancel it. They're using plugins like Stylish at least remedy the fugly icons. They're leaving DeviantArt in favor of other art sharing sites like Wisp, Weasel, ArtRift, Behance, Tagaki E, ArtSpan, Elfwood, Route 50, Fine Art America, Page World, Nabin, Artisan, Clients, Concept Art. Look at how many alternatives. I probably missed some, which would make the list even longer. And it doesn't take into account those handful of people who actually want to make a new site that would be similar to DA, but much better. They're giving up on making art altogether. They're very set. They're very saddened that DA used to be a user-friendly site 4 years ago when I joined. I felt at home. Now it's dead. It no longer feels like home. And you know...
Actually, about Weasel, I'd like to say that, as far as I could tell, Weasel ain't really much better. In fact, I've seen them make even bigger dick moves than DA. Like, just recently on Weasel, I had them take down most of my Weasel gallery. They claim that, you know, all the stuff I had up there was copyright violations. They couldn't say how or why or anything like that. And none of them were. It was only just the Paradigm Shift logos, and all the art on there that wasn't quote-unquote mine was either A, fair use, or B, like images of my friends and shit because they participated in the videos, and, you know, it was either my friends' art or literally my friends' faces. A lot of it was my face, you know. So what, I don't own the copyright on my own face now? Really? What the fuck? So instead of asking me what's with all this, they're like, no, we're just going to accuse you of copyright infringement and not even ask you to prove anything. And then they're like, well, but if you want, you could embed your videos in HTML uploads on our Weasel site there, just so long as you don't use the images that, you know, we took down and that we don't like. And it's like, if they had paid attention to anything, they'd know that those images are the image thumbnails for the video, and those are uploaded as the YouTube thumbnails. So even if I freaking embedded it, it would still show the images that they don't like. And, you know, I mean, I went over all this with them in a reply, and I'm like, why would I want to bother, you know, re-uploading all that, knowing that the same thing's probably going to happen again? I mean, why do I want to upload anything to this site anymore? You just, like, took down everything. Mm-hmm. And then you made this false accusation. Didn't even ask questions. Just, you know, just took it all down. I'm like, you know, why would I want to upload anything here anymore?
Mm-hmm.
After being treated like that, no way.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I would not recommend Weasel, and I can't speak to the others that were listed because I've never used them, so I can't say either way. But definitely would not recommend Weasel. Weasel is appropriately named. Bunch of fucking weasels. Anyway, moving on.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, it's, yet again, it's pathetic. And you know what, even though I've been here for less than 4 months, I felt no change too, ranging from things I hear from people that happened when I wasn't around, removal of webcams, the new logo, having the staff count, etc., to more recent BS, site simplification, art theft discussion, and now this. All of these events pile up and damage the site more and more. You've scared great and promising artists off of DA, and or even making art altogether, the exact opposite of what the site should do. How you should have done it. A small gradual increase, not boom, now $20 more for no new features. Why? Because shut up and give me money. Or announce that the prices are going to rise in a week or so. You know what would happen? People would be buying as much premiums as they could possibly afford while the price was still relatively low. You'd make a shit ton of money off of that lower price than that. I thought I wasn't providing you with enough money in the first place. And then it shows Fry from Futurama, 1 year PM for $20. Shut up and take my money. Exactly. What else should you do? Incorporate this idea and then link there. Changes to the core premium memberships. This is a long one, but here it goes. DA is a site made up of many different artists or different kinds of artists with many different kinds of goals. A one-size-fits-all premium membership is not going to work, especially when considering a good size amount of artists on this site are teens with limited incomes. There needs to be a happy medium between DA making money and the users being able to afford to keep paying DA. Many users had a hard time as it was paying for memberships, but to raise the price all the way across the board only ensures that members who are struggling to pay will drop the idea of buying a membership altogether. As it stands, there is too high a price for too few incentives for what is appearing to be a large portion of users. To remedy this, I propose that DA have three levels of premium memberships. First level, about $20 or $15 a year, ability to use custom boxes, ability to use journal skins. The target audience for this membership is teens and hobbyists who want their profiles to look different and want to express themselves but can't afford to spend a lot. Second level, about $30 to $35 a year. Everything from level one plus no ads. By keeping ads on level one, DA still gets revenue from those members seeing ads. Pulls to interact with watchers, more gallery boxes, and other customization options. The target audience would be those who want to spend a little more to not see ads and want to have greater ability to customize their profile beyond background, journals, and skins. Okay, I want to say on the ads thing, that's kind of a mute point, because if you have AdBlock Plus, you can pretty much block all DA ads anyway. So, I mean, you could have level one and still have your cake and eat it too with that one. But yeah, for the greater customization options, yeah, definitely. This would pretty much have everything a premium account would have had. And then the third level, $50 to $65 a year. Everything from levels 1 and 2 plus, set your own prices when selling art. See, I'd never use that. A special selection in the forum available only to this level of members, as 1 and 2 don't get extra forum privileges. A monthly or weekly newsletter pertaining to things happening right now in the art world geared towards people who work in the field. More options for selling their work. Coupons for art supplies and discounts with certain brands if DA could get art supply companies to advertise on DA and offer these coupons to the highest level of member only. The opportunity to take master classes online. Yeah, see, I mean, that's totally ingenious, because the second level is like what me and Dave use, because we're just hobbyists. We're just kind of, you know, we just kind of do it for fun, just to do whatever, you know. And we have everything that we want, and we never use any of the print services or commissions bullshit or any of that stuff. Not that it's bullshit. It's just, you know, we don't use any of that stuff like a lot of professional artists would, you know. So, yeah, that's ingenious. That's a good idea. The target of this level is professional artists who are working in the field currently, people who are looking to sell their art and make business connections through the site, and that's absolutely perfect. The bright orange star does not go with the rest of the site. I totally agree. It needs something that stands out, of course, but in addition to standing out, it needs to go with the rest of the site. It did that before, in my opinion. I propose that a neon green that's currently used for the submit comment button be used instead. That's already goes with DA's color scheme, yet still draws in the eye of, in the way of paying members who draws in the eye the way paying members would like. For each level of membership, the symbol next to the name could be different. For example, the first level could be a small star that's dark green, the second level could have a bigger star that's bright green, and the highest level could have an eye-catching neon green. This all also works on a psychological level. While many will be happy to have the first level of membership by having three levels, the highest level is now even more of a status symbol by knowing that only the best artists typically buy that level. More people with disposable income will buy this level to gain the level of respect. By having these three levels, you will get income of not only the teens who want a cute profile, but the people who can afford to drop more on higher level status with many benefits. As it is now, DA is only getting a certain percentage of demographic people who want a premium for whatever reason, but who can also afford $50 a year. Now, I don't really agree with that profile star system. I think that's kind of, no offense, I think that's kind of dumb, because, I mean, the system they had before they went to core, I think, was just fine, because, you know, you click on the thing and it shows you all the different levels. You know, you have your normal premium member there, you have your beta tester, you have all of that stuff. I say that's fine, you know. I say if you're really going to do anything for a tier system, instead of doing that, you just add like two more different icons that represent the second tier and the third tier, you know, and you just leave the, or you just add one for like the top tier artists, you know, the really big guys, you know, you make it like a something really unique, like a dollar sign, or, you know, something interesting that's bound to catch your eye, you know, something that's got, that looks different, you know. But as for, you know, like first and second level, you could just leave it the way it was, you know, with the little green, the green star, you know, dark filled in green star for normal premium, and then like the hollowed out star with kind of a field around it for somebody who was in, you know, say beta tester. And, you know, if you have hell freezes over, you've got the nice little orange flame next to your name, you know. And if you're just a hell freezes over without beta, you just have the filled in flame. I mean, the system the way it was just fine. It's just you could add that third level so that way you'd know, oh, they're real artists who are really in that realm. But that's just my opinion on that. But overall, yeah, that's a good idea. Anyway, please tell us what the fuck is going on. The confusion is enormous. You could have avoided the backlash altogether by informing us why you're doing this. We understand. Trust me. Better yet, if you asked the community for ways to earn more money fairly, you would have gotten great feedback. There are great educated economists out there always willing to help their beloved website in any way they can. Because apparently your staff doesn't know shit about business, obviously. Even a regular person with some common sense would not allow this thing to happen. Bada bang, bada boom, just what we're doing right now. We're pissed off about it. Yeah, because they're being arrogant shitheads.
Yeah. I mean, even like, you know, even your mom, who I'd say is just like, you know, an average lady, not an economist, or, you know, a web admin, or anybody technical.
She's a professional businesswoman, you know, she's a manager of an office, you know.
Okay. But I'm just saying, she's not like big time corporate techie, you know, building computer networks from scratch out of duct tape and barbed wire. You know, I mean, and the point is that even just like a regular, you know, working person, you know, with half a brain, average Joe, can see that this was an epic mistake. It doesn't take an economic genius to look at this and go, wow, this is a pile of shit. That's my boy.
Mm-hmm. No, it's totally a pile of crap. But anyway, number two, now the 1 month can... Now 1 month can only be given. Now I understand why this happened, because people have been buying 1 month simply to try it out or to customize their front page and then try to leave it as it is after premium expires. Not very lucrative for DA, but considering it was just $5, to be perfectly honest with you, if this was the only thing that happened, I wouldn't bat an eye. Till hell freezes over is gone. Honestly, it was a great deal for both sides. Imagine sticking with a website for 7 years just to get your money's worth. For DA, it was great because they were paid $200 straight away with a surge of money. Such a surge of money is always appreciated. That's $6.66 of a member's... That's six, six, 6.66 of a member. Damn, that sounds weird. Buying 1 year compressed to just one person. For the member, it was great because they didn't have to worry about being able to afford renewing it basically till hell freezes over. That's where the name came from. Duh. Plus, it's incredibly cool. Flame next to their username. I want that. They shot their foot with this with that decision. Yes, they did. You didn't add any new features for that horrible price. At least announce new features coming for core members. Don't expect us to blindly buy it, hopefully praying for new stuff, because the current existing perks aren't that great anyway. Here's more on that topic. Looking at this list, going through different perks, I have no problem seeing that you should pay for a few of these. What I disagree with, though, is the price. Nothing here stands out like just a reason to double the price when upgraded. When the upgraded membership went from premium to core. If you disagree with me, please feel free to comment here and send me a message, but please keep it civil. Also, please read everything before you comment so that I don't have to repeat myself. Thank you. Yeah, you can bet some people didn't even do that because people just don't read because people have their head up their ass. But anyway, false perks. When you look at the perks for becoming a core member, which are now 7 things, 2 of them are clearly not perks. Build the future. You are funding DeviantArt in the community. Thanks you. I think it's great to help out sites like DA, but I think an upgraded membership should not be about buying product and not charity. I feel this was added to the list just to make it seem like you get more than you actually are. This is not a perk. After all, it's just an effect of you choosing to pay for your membership. The core symbol, your username will include the coveted core symbol. This is simply not a perk. It's like upgrading your airline ticket to first class to get the star next to your name on your passport. It doesn't do anything, and it gives you the impression that there isn't much to the product. So we need to pretty up the list. Also, a lot of people hate that symbol, so definitely not a perk. Yeah. I mean, that's, what kind of insult is that? Oh yeah, you get this pretty little sticker that we're going to put on your arm. It's like, yeah, fuck you. 2 of the other 7 perks mentioned by DA are perks that only cover the interests of people who will buy and sell prints, even though hardly anybody, that's probably like 0.1% of people actually use the print system, because it's such a pile of junk, as I've been saying. They need to overhaul the majority of their site. It's like 5 years out of date. It was up to date when I joined, but now it's not even close to being up to date anymore. It's just broken. Because nobody is keeping an eye on any of the bugs, nobody's fixing anything. You know, all of the good hardcore techies have left. Yeah, get a free 10% discount on prints purchases. Set your own prices. Ooh, man, that was one that they could have done 5 years ago. Maybe we should let artists set their own prices. Gee, you think? I'm sure they've probably been nagging you that one for probably about the last 5 years. That's probably why a majority of them left, because you weren't listening. Set the sales price on your own prints for higher royalties. Sure, throw it in there, but to be honest, I would have preferred if it was a second membership or a separate perk you could buy, as I don't feel it really does cover the interest of too many. I could be wrong, I admit that, but it seems unlikely. I'm with you there. One-time perk. 4 of the 7 perks by being a core member is covered. Now the 5th. Option to change your username. That was something that was available under the premium membership. That is not... That was added like over 2 years ago now. Get with the times, people. Like a year and a half ago. I've been able to change my username long before that. Hassle-free conversion of your account to a new name. Yeah, that's been around for a while, you morons. If this is the only reason you're getting an upgraded premium, then you can choose 1 month, which has only gone up to 6 points since changing the premium to core. So thumbs up to DA from me on this one. It's a true perk, and it's still something you can do to more or less the same price. Well, yeah, whatever. Beta test new features, the option to be a beta tester and try a features list. Yet again, this is not a perk. None of these are perks. Core is just hijacking the perks of the premium membership. They're not perks, because I was a beta tester before Core even was put on the drawing board. So, yeah. I have both. I have this one, which is the beta test account, and my main one. Then I have my stock photo account, which is the normal Core membership account. I see no difference, and I never have. I might just have never used anything that's been sent on beta test. But it's such a rare thing that it's really a perk, or is it just try to make us feel special? No, it's actually a thing, because they actually, when they do release new updates, they actually, you're the first to see it. The main thing is, if you don't use your beta test account often, you're not going to notice, because, you know, you're just not going to notice. But if you use it over a long period of time, you'll definitely notice how they make you a beta tester, because you're basically the test bed for their latest updates on the site, even though they haven't really been doing anything as of late. So beta test is kind of a mute point. You do have me there. The seventh perk is actually a true perk, but 1DA shouldn't take for granted that we like no ads. And that was something that's also not a perk, because AdBlock Plus, you can get that on Firefox and Google Chrome. If you have Internet Explorer, your shit AdBlock, I'm sorry, upgrade to something that it doesn't eat glue or horse feces. But really, the ads thing, I mean, that's kind of something that's always been available. You know, if you have AdBlock Plus, you can do that one for free. And you can also use, and if you have the premium membership beforehand, you could have no ads. So that's really not a perk that is new. Yeah, I like the perk too. You know, this is a perk I love. I'm willing to pay for it because I want DA to do well. And that is the clue here. This is the perk I choose to pay for. A lot of DA's members simply use AdBlock and then don't see these adverts. A lot of these people have talked to me over the last few days saying I should stop complaining about the price because DA needs money and I should just use the AdBlock if I think it's too expensive. And I would agree with that. I mean, if you're complaining about the price, I mean, you know, AdBlock is there for a reason. You know, before I even read that, I was just talking about that. But people, if you think that DA needs money and you use AdBlock, you are a hypocrite. Blocking adverts on DA is like stealing from, oh, I'm guilty. Oh, I'm so naughty. Oh, shame on me. I'm using AdBlock. Oh, man, I'm so evil. That's like saying using music that was recorded by the RIAA is stealing from the artist. I mean, that's like a hypocritical statement. Anyway, I'm going to be right back. I'm going to go get some more pizza and something more to drink. You can take it from here.
Hey, Rich.
Yep.
So what if you don't use AdBlock, but you never click on any ads? Are you still stealing?
Yeah. Seriously. I mean, that is like the dumbest statement. Anyway, I'll be right back, and then we can continue where we left off. So just be an advertisement until then.
All righty. Anyway, yeah, he won't be too incredibly long. I was hoping to have a few other people, at least one or two, with us here discussing this, but looks like that's probably not happening for reasons completely unknown, so... Whatever. Also, in a little while, we are going to be having another hangout, actually. And may as well add this to favorites, as long as I'm here anyway. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna go down here for a second. Because, or no, wait, where was that? I'm looking for something very specific to be able to finish my freaking thought here. Please bear with me. I just want to get the name correct. I would prefer not to bastardize this. I want to make sure I'm saying it properly. But because there's like 20 pages, you know, worth of this displayed on one, that's the way DA works with this, and I tend to do a lot of image embedding and video embedding and stuff like that in my journals. These, you know, 20 item, you know, main page list sort of things can sometimes take a minute or two to fully load, and then in the meantime the browser's being just a little bit jittery because it's just trying to load like shit tons at once. Okay, come on. And as long as this is on this, now this just like jumped up. Come on, stupid. Okay, that's going smoother. Little voting poll. In your opinion, the DeviantArt staff cares more about 19 Deviant said being greedy control freaks who could care less about the DeviantArt community. 7 said I don't know enough about the DeviantArt staff yet to form an opinion. And 2 said the people who make up the DeviantArt community. So there seems to be, you know, almost 70% of people who have voted on that so far are pretty much thinking that the DeviantArt staff seems to care more about jacking up prices and bending us over and raping us than actually about the community. And I concur. So yes, I posted a DA features thing, which is about people's art getting featured, you know, right here on PSEC with Hangouts and, you know, talking about different stuff and so on and so forth. And I've got four takers on that. Come on, my browser. I've got 4 takers on that so far. I guess there's just a lot loaded, so this is being a little slow. My apologies for that. Okay. So yeah, the one that's actually not listed here yet, ironically, is going to be the first hangout we're doing today. Gurundive, GERUNDIVE. I'm not exactly sure the specifics of what we're going to be talking about. I guess we'll figure something out. Whereas with the others, like the RPM kid, you know, we're going to be talking about art and confidence and, you know, social anxiety and self-esteem and things like that. Troa Storm, she's going to be probably speaking more about cosplay stuff because she kind of informed me that apparently there's this stereotype that people have about cosplayers that, you know, supposedly they're real arrogant and bitchy and think they're better than everybody else and whatever, when in her experiences, you know, most of the cosplayers she's run into are really more, you know, empathetic and caring and considerate and so on and so forth. So, you know, I think she's mostly going to be talking about, you know, the stereotype of that sort of stuff. And then Hopebringer Jim, haven't talked to her specifically yet about exactly what she wants to do or, you know, how or whatever. But I do know that the RPM Kid and Troa Storm are going to be similarly themed as far as, you know, societal paradigms and self-image and self-worth and stereotyping and you know, all these different sort of topics that are like that. So in a little while, which is actually going to be around 8 p.m. Eastern time, that's approximately around the time that I'll be contacting Gurundive and getting her into a hangout, and then, you know, we'll move forward from there. So that's 8 p.m. Eastern, 7 p.m. Central, and it's 4:10 Central right now. So just wanted to mention that for anybody who happens to be listening live or anything like that, so that you guys know that we're going to have another hangout here shortly. And Rich, are you back?
Yes, I am.
Okay, I guess we can continue.
Anyway, the design your own profile and mass upload of images, yet again. Another thing that Core is not providing that's anything new. You're essentially getting the same for much more, and in some ways less for much more. It's just, it's bullshit. But anyway, moving on, besides that, we've discussed that one quite a bit. Right, and then it's like there's another thing, the reason I'm against Core. The prices are not the only thing that I personally disagree with when it comes to the Core update, but this post is dedicated to the side of the argument. If you would like to read more about the different reasons, then please go here. And then it looks like down below, DeviantArt needs money and all that stuff. Of course, we've already talked about, you know, Core and the other side. I'm adding this bit here because I see a lot of people talking about DA needs money, how they have cut 50% of their paying staff, and that this increase in prices is the cover in the loss that they have in other places. Well, instead of going into details on this whole thing, I'm just going to say right now, as an amateur economist, it's like, well, basically what happens is if you become self-righteous and arrogant and care less about the customer and more about your profits, what do you expect to happen? Any people who gave a damn about the site and about the people on the site have obviously left, at least at the latest a couple of years ago. And now we're just obviously sitting around with a bunch of inept morons who have been picking their nose ever since and don't really know what they're doing. You know, Spied, you know, which is the DA head guy.
And just to make the context clear, you are talking, as far as the people who left 2 years ago, you're talking about the admins, you're not talking about regular users.
No, I'm talking about the admins, yeah. I'm talking, yeah, that's what I was just talking about, you know, right there. I was talking about the admins. I'm pretty sure I made that clear. Yeah, the reason why basically what's going on right now is, you know, it's starting to become apparent that there was obviously a scuffle between the admins who did give a shit and the admins who didn't give a shit, and now we see who's won that one, and it's the admins who don't give a shit, unfortunately, and all the good guys have left and probably are still watching and checking in with horror every now and again, seeing what the site's turning into. The only person I really noticed that's still here from the old days is Spide, who is DA's original CEO, who I believe at one time lived over in Greece. But Spide, it's kind of, you know, I don't think he really is paying attention to what's going on around the site, unfortunately. He just kind of does his own thing and doesn't really care anymore because he's too, you know, successful to care, I guess. But, you know, I remember there was a time when he did give a shit about the community and, you know, actually cared about what was going on with the site. Now he just seems to be kind of disconnected. But anyway, it's just, you know, yeah, that's what happens. You know, you start taking away stuff and you start treating people like crap after they've helped build a part of the site or do something tremendous for the site or add something to the site. And, you know, the most you get is maybe, well, the most you do get is just a premium membership. I mean, hell, I know plenty of people on the site that haven't really built anything, but, you know, like me, they've added something like a really cool group, or they've added something that, you know, contributes to the diversity of the site, who are in, you know, who deserve to have a status as a senior member, you know, to be recognized in the community. But staff is so unattentive that they don't really notice nor, you know, pay attention.
Little historical tidbit that most people don't know about is way back in the day, there was a site that was kind of a split off from DeviantArt, and it predates mp3.com. is actually the first music site on the internet, period, ever, finito. And it was called D Music, which is short for Deviant Music. And that site also ran boycottriaa.com. That was boycott-riaa.com. They even contracted me for a bit, so I was working with them for a while, and it was pretty cool. Generally, the only problems that I had over there are, okay, that was weird. I just heard like a little ding. Anyway, the only problems that I had over there were the problems that eventually sent the site into total ruin, and now it doesn't exist. And that being just, you know, I'll be as polite as I can about this. The people who worked there just kept getting increasingly more arrogant, although they never made it into this big, huge, whopping company. There was mainly one guy through which all control centered around, and he really kind of fought expansion, and he fought change, and he was really all about sameness. His name was Larry E. Feldman, attorney at law. He was a copyright lawyer fighting the RIAA, and, you know, he was all for fair use and things like that. I'm fairly certain he's dead now. I know he was, after I stopped working for him, he was starting to get kind of physically sick. I don't know the exact problems or whatever, but I had heard that he died. Maybe that was a rumor or something, but I'm fairly certain that he actually died. But yeah, that site kind of collapsed under its own weight, and it didn't get anywhere near as big as DeviantArt is right now. But it did collapse because of arrogance, and because, you know, what the people wanted wasn't really taken into consideration, and they wanted sameness and no real expansion, and they wanted conformity. So yeah, I mean, I hope that DeviantArt does not share a similar fate, but you know, let's remember that the globalist big corporation idea of too big to fail is a delusion. So anybody who thinks that DeviantArt is too big to fail, well, the bigger they are, the harder they fall. So just saying.
and that's very true. Yeah, and kind of on that conformity and sameness note, I mean, you know, and the arrogance thing, I mean, it kind of reminds me, it's like, you know, even websites aren't immune to the lessons of history. I mean, look at what happened to France. The upper aristocracy and upper class became so arrogant of the lower classes that they eventually came to the point where they said, let them eat cake. Well, the masses took care of that. They ended up storming the palace and killing everybody in the palace. Unfortunately, the French Revolution is not a good example of what happened. That's basically the worst possible example of what happens when there's a revolution. But the basic example of that is, you know, don't give, you know, the people who have put their time, their effort, their love, their consideration, their care into building something, and then give them the shaft, because number one, the shaft is going to backfire on you and it's not going to be pretty. You know, that's just my two cents worth. I mean, you know, just the immaturity that it takes for the staff to be doing what they're doing right now is just totally, 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 totally below them. And it's sad. It's sad that they're taking this attitude of, you know, oh, well, you know, we're so big now, we don't really need you anymore, so we're just going to raise prices as a, you know, a thank you, even though that's really just kind of like a fuck you type thing. We don't like you anymore. DA is becoming less and less about the artist and more about the profits that they rake in, and that's a very slippery slope that history does not view kindly on, whether it's a website or a powerhouse economy of the world. You know, it's a very dangerous game of slippery slopes to play. So, anyway, that's kind of my two cents on that. But anyway, on to reading the rest here. Rebranding the site. In December 2014, DA did a rebranding with a new logo and everything. Rebranding was time-consuming and costly, and if DA is struggling financially so shortly after they did a massive rebranding, then I feel like there is something fundamentally wrong with how the site is run. Don't get a rebranding confused with an upgrade. Upgrades need to be done all the time and needs to happen for the site company and slash company to survive. A rebranding is different, and this rebranding wasn't sorely sought after or needed, and I agree with that 100%. So if that's the reason for their poor economy, then it really should be something they should fix without hurting its members. I agree with that statement 100%. Donation pool, crowdfunds, and volunteers. DA members DA love, and most people will try and pitch in if they can. If they hear about something they love, struggle. If DA went out and informed people of their trouble, then they would most likely get sympathy instead of this anger, and they could have asked for advice, even, and things like donation pulls, crowdfunding, adding extra volunteers would have been the answer. That's that way everybody who wanted to pitch in a little, maybe some who couldn't afford an entire core membership, could pitch in with what she or he could.
Patreon is a pretty cool service that even I'm considering using at some point in the future. I'm not really prepared for that now, because Patreon is a service based on, you know, you get a little something for your donation. It's not,
well, everybody I know in the anthro community, the anthro artist community, like my friend James, James News, who uses Patreon all the time, you know, and it's a great spot to fund artists. I mean, it's a good,
yeah,
it's a good program.
And
if a site like DA and teamed up with Patreon, I mean, how much easier would it make things? They could add a widget, a Patreon DA widget.
And just to make the point of how good Patreon can be, I think you already know where I'm going with this. Mm-hmm. Nixie Pixel. I mean, you know, she's just an awesome gal, regular gal, happens to be hardcore into gaming and Linux and all that. Makes money on YouTube, but she didn't really know the shall we say, the tricks required to, you know, get through some of the common YouTube stupidities, which, you know, I won't really go into here. I mean, I've talked about the stuff in other, you know, hangouts, and we'll talk about it in the future. But let's just say she got supremely frustrated. But within that frustration, she discovered Patreon, and look at how great she's doing right now. 638 patrons, and she's getting $8,101 per month. Let's literally do the math.
Mm-hmm. Times 12.
That's $97,212. And that's just with Patreon.
Well,
and
that,
people can give as little as $1 per month.
And yet again, that's, you know, that's before taxes, mind you.
But still, obviously, but still not bad.
No, 97 grand a year. I mean, that's not only is that more than livable, that's like you can own a house, have groceries, and a nice brand new car out front, no problem.
Yeah, I mean, and this is on donations.
Yeah, and that's just sheer donations. Plus, she's probably got a real job on the side. You know, if she's making like...
YouTube is her job, making videos and helping people with Linux and doing gaming stuff and showing up at conventions and things. Hacker conventions, open source meetups, electronic shows, gamer cons, so on and so forth.
Well, in that case, I mean, you know, does she have any stats on how much she's making on YouTube? She's got to be like $2,000 a month.
I'm not exactly sure. She's made some videos about it as far as her frustration, but she didn't really go so far that I could see as far as stating the specifics about her finances.
But I mean, even still, yeah. I mean,
she complains on here a bit too. YouTube has been going through drastic changes, false copyright claims, it's so on and so on. DMCA's, So she doesn't know how to, you know, how to roll with the punches on that and prosper in that, because it can be a bit of a cutthroat, you know, environment. I mean, yeah, you can make a shit ton of money on YouTube. I make money on YouTube, and I made more until they took down my other channel, but I'll rebuild back up again. But at the height of my channel, I was making a grand a month. So I mean, like, that's not bad, just making videos and shit. So, you know,
I was going to say, I'd assume with her attention, I imagine she gets, because she's a pretty girl. I'd assume she's probably making 1500 or $2,000 a month. I'm just making an estimation. Don't know if that's true. Don't know if that's false. Don't know. I'm just making an assumption based on her popularity, because she's kind of exploded in the YouTube community.
People If I had to guess, I would say that, no, this is purely a guess, I'd say she probably got up to something like $5,000 a month, and then, you know, she got used to a certain level of, you know, living based on that, and then with some of the shenanigans that YouTube started pulling with, you know, oh, prove you own this, and you know, false third-party matches. Like, I've had people try to third-party match my stuff that, like, I was using my stuff and none of it was theirs, but, like, the computer fucked up or something and I had to dispute it and so on and so forth. So, you know, with that and not knowing how to roll with those punches, or maybe not having the time to know how to roll with those punches, I'd say maybe her $5,000 income dropped down to $2,000. And I mean, if you've got your budget set a certain way, being used to one thing, and then all of a sudden it takes a dive, it's like, you know, all of a sudden you're owing bills and stuff and you're like freaking out. So she was definitely going through a bit of a freak out, like, you know, what the fuck, I was making this much, I have this much bills, and now this dropped to this much and I still have this much bills, you know, what the fuck do I do?
Either way, regardless of semantics, as I was about to say, regardless if she's making $2,000 a month, you know, I'm just going to make that the safe estimate. I'm not going to go to $5,000 a month. I don't think she's quite that popular yet.
She probably was at one point. I mean, she got pretty popular.
Yet again, I'm going with current stats here. Let me finish. You know, even with, you know, her Patreon, and, you know, that's still like $10,000 a month. So that's like, you know, hell, you know, 10 times 12. I mean, you know, do the math on that, you know.
Yeah. Well, then let's make the bigger point. If one person like her could do that, what could DeviantArt do? They've got like, you know, a jillion freaking users on there. Like, what was it? Like 20 million, 50 million, whatever the fuck it was.
It's like 25 or 30 million at least.
Yeah. Now because
my Deviant number, which I forget, I should have linked it on my front page, but you can actually, if you go into your comments section, mm-hmm. and you're like typing in a embedded comments thread, you know, you can actually locate your actual Deviant number ID, like the mm-hmm. actual number that you are on the website listed as Deviant 15. I'm like Deviant 15 million. It's on my front page. I did copy it and put it on my page. I'm Deviant 15,075,850. So I'd imagine by now there's probably at least, I'd have to say 25 or 30 by now, 30 million.
Yeah. Imagine if 25% of those people donated a dollar on Patreon.
Oh, yeah, a DA.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That'd be a lot of fucking money.
That'd be tons of money, yeah.
And then DA wouldn't need to be a bunch of fucking douchebags. But yeah, we've definitely made the point here.
Yeah. But I mean, yeah, you know, they could... all DA'd have to do is look at guys like me, guys like you, people like Rochelle, people like Kristen, people like, you know, there's so many people like Bagheera 3005 on DA, Mike Brown, who posts really cool stuff on DA. They just have to look to people like that and go, hey, do you want to be a senior member or a, you know, a volunteer on the site, you know, and help out? You know, there would be more than enough people if they would just go to the community and fucking stop being arrogant little dicks and ask and say, hey, what can we do to make it better? See, if they simply came out for the 15th anniversary and said, you know, hey, we've been doing great so far, you know, if they hadn't fucked up the first time with that dumb little logo there and kept it the way it was, you know, and they just waited until the 15th anniversary to do the rebranding, you know. They could have said, hey, you know, we've been doing great as a site so far. What can we do to make the next 5 years even more incredible? You know?
Yeah, and how about we not make it a fucking Third Reich symbol?
Yeah, yeah. Why don't we do something like some other creative people have come up with where you actually add, like, you have the neon green and then you have a dark round L kind of for where the D is and then have another, you know, dark kind of area for the A, you know? Instead of just this little Third Reich looking little symbol that doesn't even make sense.
Sorry, some pop went down the wrong hole.
Yeah, it happens. But, you know, yeah.
And then the frickin' bleed und breed art.
Yeah, that's not it's like propaganda pulled out of Mein Kampf or something like that. You know, bleed for the Aryan race bullshit.
Yeah, some sort of like, women are nothing more than something to stick your dick into and make babies. Bleed und breed. It's like, oh god. There's a lot of women that got really fucking pissed off when they saw the bleed and breed thing. They're like, fuck you.
Well, yeah, you know how many people that's going to turn off? I mean, that's, you know, that's Orwellian Third Reich stuff. But anyway, donation pool, crowdfunds, and volunteers, other ways of getting money if in desperate need. DA members love DA. Most people try to pitch in if they can and hear about something. Or did I already read that?
You read that already. You read about half of it anyway.
Half of it, okay. Crowdfunding, adding extra volunteers could have been the answer. That way everybody who wanted to pitch in a level, maybe some couldn't afford an entire core membership, could pitch in. And on all of this could come on top of the existing paying members. Well, I mean, yeah, they could do all of that on top of, like, you know, maybe teaming up with Patreon. They're a big enough site that I'm sure Patreon wouldn't have an issue, you know, you know, developing some, you know, like co-funded type app or widget on DA, you know, like have a
or something
Patreon, you know, donation app instead of like that points donation widget. Add mm-hmm. something else like a Patreon donation widget, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, how cool would that be? Not only for like the super premium third tier artists, but for like the second and even first tier artists, you know, not only be able to get points, but able to get actual money. And hell, a DA could be really cool and do something with PayPal and, you know, all of that stuff. I mean, there's just so many options of what they could do for money. And if they would allow Google, you know, analytics and Google, you know, crowdfunding and all that stuff, you know, ad services and stuff, they'd be able to make legit amounts of money. But instead, they just decide to be dumb little, you know, pissant fucks about it. Anyway, moving on to the journal. Side note, even you failed at advertising that quarry. You didn't mention the profile customization or uploading many things once scheduling. What a fail. The new symbols, the vivid orange, unoriginal stars, would totally clash with the site's theme color. I agree with that. And again, I understand why you did this. You wanted to persuade our subconsciouses into buying core, since the phrase buy core membership can be found everywhere. Core membership lets you organize with gallery subfolders. Upgrade. Become core. Upgrade now. You know.
The core is mother, the core is father. Sorry, that was a Babylon 5 reference.
Extended stats are only available for the galleries of core members. Drag and drop any of our stash images into your comment or add new image to use immediately. Core membership allows you to use this feature to upgrade search images from throughout DeviantArt, including your friends. Core membership allows you to use this feature to upgrade. Polls. This is a premium widget. Upgrade to a core membership to get this great widget. Core members receive 10 gigabytes of storage. Become a core member. Upgrade. Everywhere. You need to make money. So that's understandable, but distracting us with eye-smitting orange every time someone like... Can't hardly read that because it's fuzzy.
I can read it, but I can't pronounce it too well.
Italia Kincana. Lydia
Kincana. Whatever.
Yeah, Lydia Kincana appears on the screen is not understandable. It won't make us buy it anyway because we're going to be smitting other people's eyes too. Just a little empathy is enough to understand.
Smiting. Smiting, I do believe, is the word. Smiting. As in, like, you know, like Bruce Almighty. Smite me, almighty smiter!
Oh, smiting, yeah. Smiting other people's eyes. Okay, yeah. Smiting. Right. Just a little empathy is enough to understand that sentence. Come on. Yeah, sometimes it's like weird. It clears up and then it like blurs out a little bit. So it kind of like fuzzes everything. So it makes it hard. Mm-hmm. But the core isn't the only reason to this backlash. A lot of previous shit has accumulated. I need you to understand this. The rebellion isn't solely for the core to die. Though it would be awesome if we got premium membership back. It's also primarily about the fact that the staff doesn't listen to the users. How many times in the past have they made an update that nobody wanted, and despite the backlash, the update persisted? Too many for the community's liking. When it happened again, they finally had enough. Worse, every journal entry they make, they go, let us hear your opinions, feedback. They get heaps of it and completely ignore it. Not cool, DA. Am I the only one around here that fucking hates core? Oh, am I the only one around here that's using hick terminology? Am I the only one around here that fucking hates core? I get it. What we members can do, don't buy core, join anti-core groups, use anti-core stamps, icons, emotes, etc. Sign this petition already signed in May. If you haven't heard about it yet, you have been living under a rock. I'll fight against core fags, trolls who defend core. I'm not saying everyone who defends core is a faggot. Comment on staff's profiles, journals, comments, every word. Force them to talk about this matter. We will not be silenced. Make anti-core journals or deviations. Or if you're too lazy, just spread this like fucking wildfire. Tomorrow, while writing this journal, is DA's 15th birthday. Do you know what would be the best birthday gift for DeviantArt and its members? Bring back premium membership with the good old symbols and all their former glory, reverting the old packages to their prices, even less for a period of time, as compensation for moral losses. You'll make a lot of money because people will be buying heaps while it's still cheap. Adding, or at least promising, new fancy features make premium membership worth it. Listening to the community, not outrageously neglecting it. They're really starting, they really talk good ideas. Starting a GoFundMe, Patreon, or some other Kickstarter. That way wealthy users will support you while the poorer ones will still be able to afford premium. Explaining what the hell is going on with DeviantArt Incorporated to the community. We really want to know what you're doing. Don't sprinkle us with artificially positive PR bullshit. We want to know the truth. After you're done with the core, revert to the unwanted changes like the site simplification messages, notifications, bullshit, for example. Bring back the webcams or implement this brilliant idea. support.deviantart.com/entries something.
Let's see if this is the one we've already read or if this is different.
Yep, we already read that.
Yeah, so he linked that more than once.
Yep.
Yeah, DA, if you stop neglecting the community and actually listen to their great advice, that'd be great.
And start communicating with the community like you used to several years ago. What happened? Why is DeviantArt rotten to the core? Rotten to the core. That's a pun, I know. Why have you fixed DX? Why have you fired
DX? Why have you fired DX?
That's what I was just about to say. Yeah.
Without notice, amongst the rest of the rest of half your staff.
Mm-hmm. Please, DeviantArt, we're begging you to look.
I want to see this. Dear DeviantArt, I'm refusing to use the rebranded name because I'm annoyed about the rebrand. I'm annoyed about your direction, your lack of focus in key areas, and your lack of communication. I said I'd never be a bitter former staff member, but it seems that I am. Oh, yeah. It looks like he's really got some beef here. Spide, tell people what's happening because people deserve to know. Your staff deserve to know. The people that have thought this is their home for years deserve to know. I've been here 12 years, and alongside from the few months that I've logged on virtually every day, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera, da, 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 da. I have defended you for years, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. But right now I can't do it, man. I don't know if this is coming from you or pressure from those around you, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera, da, da, da. Ultimately, losing my job here hurt me both financially and personally, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Yeah, this is...
I remember DXD when he was one of the big guys. And it's funny, me and him have that in common. I mean, I met my ex-girlfriend through the site, and we felt madly in love. I mean, you know, we became... You know, we wanted to get married and all that stuff. I mean, unfortunately, it didn't work out. But, you know, DeviantArt's been a place where, you know, I've explored different things like I never thought possible, you know. And Dave, maybe you could copy that entire, you know, journal in the editor thing and, like, send
me... I'm actually just adding it to this existing journal.
I know, but I'm asking what I'm saying. You're not getting what I'm saying. I'm saying... If you could copy that entire thing and send it to me so that way, therefore, I could upload it in my own journal on my own page, I'd like to do that.
Okay, well, why don't I just send you the link then?
Well, I don't know if everything... Well, no, it would, because I'm a premium. Because I'd be able to copy everything.
Uh-huh.
Because it's all DA stuff. No, not that. You're still not getting what I'm saying. I'm saying your journal, as in your journal, as in yours, the one that you were on, this one with Barack Obama saying DeviantArt Core, that one right there.
Oh, that one.
Because it'll have all of the information, all of that, all there embedded.
Yeah.
It's the whole nine yards.
Well, I'm still periodically updating it as I find new things. So whatever you put into yours will be obsolete as soon as I add anything new. But there you go.
Just let me know when you add something and I can add that too.
Kind of like how I added this, see, Dear DeviantArt, you know, from DXE. So I just added that into here so that people can, you know, can see that.
Mm-hmm.
So, okay, moving on. Please, DeviantArt.
Yeah, hold on. Let me go to my page here really quick and make a journal about core.
I should do one of Fella with a worm coming out of his head that says rotten to the core. Anyway, please, DeviantArt, we're begging you to listen. I can promise all of your financial problems will go away if you don't waste your money and if you start making the users happy. Money will come flying into your bank accounts if you give us what we want. And then I guess this is bad English or something. 2015 DA does not simply revert the shitty change.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm not sure what that's even attempting to say, but disclaimer, I do not own the images other than the ones and fives. Just click on them and you'll be taken to the artist who made them. Update number 11. I'm having a Karmas camera syndrome. I'm fixing every little detail I can possibly find someone to help me update just before going to bed. Look at what a long day it's been for me. Total keys to clicks, etc., etc. The little stats thing. About 2,000 keystrokes and 1,000 clicks were for anti-core unrelated stuff. So it's safe to say that I spent 22,000 keystrokes and 2,000 mouse clicks for the drama for only this one day. This doesn't take into account the countless taps I've made on my phone when I was still on vacation. I don't know what else to say. Oh, and most important of all, anti-core rebellion spread like a wildfire. 'Tis not mine, of course. Update 27/8/2015. They finally addressed it, and there's still some issues. Heidi.
That's Heidi. That was the one I was talking about. Heidi.
What about her?
That was the gal I was talking about last night. You're like, who's Heidi? And I'm like, the gal who writes those journals. That's Heidi. She's one of the moderators. Anyway, I'll see if I can't try to read this.
Apparently Heidi is in favor of the people who don't like core and is against core herself.
No, she was the one who finally made that journal about what core is about. That was the one I was telling you about.
Oh, the one who was like, everybody loves core.
That's the one. That's Heidi. Yep. She's the one who wrote that journal. God. Yes. As in yes.
Gulp, gulp, gulp the Kool-Aid.
Uh-huh. Hey, even though I'm not a beta tester and I'm not currently able to afford core, I could help with translating the site. I could help with translating the site into Polish. And now on to the rest. Heidi, I still got to give you some honest, tough love. That's still not transparent enough. You should have put more emphasis into the... Can you zoom in on that a little bit? Because that is really tall, really tiny text. Okay. Still not transparent enough. You should have put more emphasis on the "we value every deviant paid membership or not" part, because you're just saying all deviants are important and valued doesn't necessarily mean everyone's going to believe it. If I was you, I would word it this way: core members are called that because they sustain DeviantArt Inc. as a business. At its core, we believe that every deviant contributing their time into uploading art, commenting, faving, featuring other people's art, etc., already helps sustain and build DeviantArt as a community. And we fully understand that some of those members simply can't afford to put money into it. We value them nonetheless. That's still just saying something, but worded in a much more honest and pleasing way. Let us feel your love. Please, if you acknowledge my honest advice, I would be so grateful. It doesn't please me to criticize core, and as you can see, I'm not doing everything I can to help this site change for the better. I'm doing everything I can to help this site change for the better, although I'm not an educated PR expert. I do love the amount of empathy and common sense to know what
you do. I do have the amount.
You see, it's fucking tiny ass comments, or it's tiny letters. It's kind of hard to read. I do have the amount of empathy and common sense to know what would be the best way to please the community, because I know what I'd like to be told, even though I'm not a long-time deviant. Been here for 4 months or so. I fucking love this site. I love the art I see here. I love the people. And
4 months or so, and he gets more views than most people get, having been here for years. That's interesting.
Yeah. It's kind of strange. Oh, well, whatever. I love the people I met. I think he means to say meet. And still meet here. I absolutely love and adore how good of an opportunity to be noticed it is. It's nice that you finally addressed it. However, I still see some issues that have to be worked on. I wouldn't be writing both my long-ass journal about core as well as this comment if I didn't love this site so much. Unlike the countless rabid core haters, I'm here to help.
And
then she replies. Hi, Panther PL. We're saying the same thing, mostly. Here's a reply I left on a comment recently where I explained where it takes contributions of all kinds to make DeviantArt what it is. All are valuable. All are important. Thank you for your support, Heidi. Well, I like this site too, but core is not the answer.
Then he adds at the bottom, I admit I'm rather skeptical about this, but I decided not to reply in an oh really I don't believe you fashion, and instead focus on something else and try to turn the staff's attention to this journal.
Well, what about this red ship, the fox comment up here? Also, I'd like to feature a golden comment of a guy called Red Ship the Fox. Comments.deviantart-right there. Okay.
No.
Somebody fucked up on their little
deviant. No, hold on. No, they didn't. Firefox did.
There we go. Red Ship the Fox. I feel as though I should tear this to shreds, explaining why everything about this core is majorly misleading and wrong, but I'll give it some dignity and be the most professional I can about my diagnosis of this. I'll tackle this in the preceding style: symbol, naming, prices, affordability, rebilling and rebilling, cancellation, communication, and brief summary. First, the symbol. I personally understand the extreme hatred for the symbol only. I have my dislikes of it, though I'd first like to say that it was fine the way it was. It didn't need to change. I agree with that. All that I see has happened with it is precious time. Is that precious time was put into it to take on an orange circle around it and see change from a site appropriate shading of dark green to white. I would halfway accept the symbol change if it wasn't an eyesore. It's a very horrible color to have chosen it. It doesn't match the site's color scheme. Its orange color is out of place. When I see it, it's almost blinded by its absurd radiance.
Do I need to make the font bigger?
No, just stop moving the screen and I'll tell you when to move it, because then it throws me off a place and I'm kind of, you know, scrambling to find where the fuck I am.
Okay.
And this is not a good thing. Yes, it's noticeable, but no, it shouldn't be noticed in this way. If it was changed to a matching site schemed color rather than an eye-piercing shade of orange, I would accept its change. Naming, I'll start this off by saying that every member of DeviantArt that contributes to something, whether it be submitting a picture, commenting on something, interacting with someone, they become a core member of the site, they become a part of it. In saying this, a staff member has said nearly the same thing not long ago, and I'm sure that the staff member's comment was written well into the core membership development based on its timestamp. And in this staff member's comment, I firmly believe that anyone who contributes something is a core member, regardless of what they are called by the site standards. And renaming premium to core, you have essentially given the bird to all of us paying members, saying that we're nothing special because we've given money to support the site. In my viewing, I feel as though everyone who's had premium has now been degraded. Even the name makes people not want it. Yeah, essentially. Not under pricing, and boy, this one is a barn full. I could talk all day why these new prices are going to lower your paychecks, but I'll summarize my complaints on it now. I'll start with stating at least roughly the previous prices. 1 month had a cost between $3.34 US dollars. That's not really necessary to add, but I guess it is. And $3.90. A 3 month premium membership had a price of between $12.40 US and $12.99 US. 12 month membership had a cost of between $27.48 US and $29.97 US. 2 year membership cost was about $49.99 US, and a 7 year membership till hell freezes overhead price tag of, if not exactly, $208.13 US. Lucky few who came into money were able to purchase 7 years, as were most of us who could afford 1 year, too, if we had to scavenge by with skipping a couple of meals here and there. Now onto the new prices, which seem to have a fetish for the number five. 1 month, 1 month has the cost of $5 US, 3 months has the cost of $15 US, and the 1 year costs $50 US. Now, here's where I and most others draw issues. A large amount of
I didn't know they did a five for 1 month. Apparently they did that.
I didn't even see that. They must have just added
it. Or either they just added it or they just killed it.
Yeah.
I'm not sure which.
Because I haven't seen the 1 month anywhere. I've only seen the 3 month and 1 year.
Yeah.
A large amount of us cannot afford $50 all at once without skipping meals or skimping on the bills. I've seen long premium members saying that they can't sustain it at these prices. Essentially, we're paying for one year the price that used to be 2 years without having anything else given, which brings up another issue. We pay more but get nothing more. I will state that I know sites need money to sustain themselves. There are multiple ways to gain this money, which are acceptable ways than to just raise prices out of the affordability range. And now you can scroll to the and with that, I'm leading to affordability. I stated before that a lot of us can't sustain, and with that, I'm leading to into affordability. As I stated before that a lot of us can't sustain our memberships at these prices without making self-hurting sacrifices of some kind and degree. I can't afford $50, and I know your rebuttal for this would be, that is why we have a monthly and quarterly billing plan, which I would say that I would be paying $10 more overall, putting me in an even tighter financial position than I already am to keep buying premium, to keep my premium going. I'd have to skip full days without eating or all out skipping a bill payment, losing me something as much as power, water, or even internet. If I lost internet, I wouldn't be able to use premium anyways, wasting a good month while I gathered the money to pay for the late fees. I could accept a $10 raise, but not a 20. But not 23. You may think these prices are reasonable, but for those of us who have to choose to maintain premium or go without some meals or paying bills is not reasonable. Some of us can barely afford the memberships we have now. Price raises. Wow, man, he typoed bad. Raising the prices have done you no favors. I'm sure some staff members have seen a drop in their paycheck by now because of it, too, or soon will not just be cut from the team. Or soon, if not, just being cut from the team. I have no right to bring this up, but the save keyframe pool gathered well over $15,000 U.S. in one day, I believe possibly over $25,000 U.S. overall of keyframe, has that much of a loving audience. You do too, DeviantArt. Goodwill can be a powerful force. Now for rebilling, no one likes to be forced into a rebilling cycle. There was a reason you provided an option of it before, not to be rude, but back then you used your brains. You figured out that we want a choice. Some of us want it and some of us don't, but it seems you don't care enough to think about giving it choice in the matter. I, for one, want the choice back. I don't want to be forced into something I can't stop. I choose to not be rebilled, and I won't accept being forced to pay if I can't. And if the funds are deducted from my PayPal account, we will have words, nasty words, in fact, lawyer present words. Now, to cancellation fees, all I have to say is to talk to my lawyer. I won't accept having to pay my way out of something. I should have an option of ending in the first place, which I did. And you've removed said option. The one and only exception is in the process of buying a house and backing out. I've heard nasty stories about DeviantArt going after people for money to cancel their membership, rebilling, or cancel wholesale. I personally won't be paying to be a victim in that. If there are no cancellation fees, please state so. I would fucking sue them if they did that. Fuck you. I think somebody ought to get a class action lawsuit going against these guys. Force them to go back, you know, force them through blackmail to go back to the way they were. Anyway.
Maybe somebody will make a site that looks similar but different to DA better and compete directly with DA.
Well, yeah.
I mean, I've seen a lot of the alternative sites, which are nowhere near as good as DA. I mean, like, this one, which wasn't on that person's list, but this I found through a journal of some other deviant who said that they left DA because it's gone to shit, and they're just leaving their DA up account, that DA account up as a placeholder. They said they went to this site, and it's called ArtStation. And, I mean, I haven't really explored it that much, but so far it looks like a lot more basic than DA. It doesn't really, you know, look like there's a whole lot of customization or anything, but it does also seem more like it's geared to, like, a more professional environment, and, you know, they have, you know, video categories and, you know, all sorts of different stuff and so on. Again, I haven't taken, like, an uber close look at it, so I don't know, you know, whether, you know, how many users they have or the quality of their site or, you know, how great or not great it is or what have you. I haven't really explored it yet, but yeah, there's tons of other different sites out there. None as good as DA that I've seen. But that may change if enough people get mad.
On something that needed to be done, but was greatly ignored, communication to the community. I have to say, I'm disappointed in every single staff member here on DeviantArt, all of you. There's no reason why don't... I'm going to go get a bottle of water. My throat's getting dry.
Yep. Okay. I know that'll only take you a minute. So, yeah, there's all these different interesting turn of events so far with this, and so many people, you know, speaking out about this. I've noticed that a lot more people are starting to speak out about a great many things just in general within the world. And I think that it's a really nice trend, a nice change. You know, the silent majority are starting to speak up in the face of the minority of fools that everybody assumes that the fools represent the majority, because the majority never speak up and contradict them. So it's definitely been a year of action as far as, you know, people doing what they had not previously had the balls to do. And it's also been a year of action with, you know, idiots being even more stupid and making even more epically tragic, you know, fuck-ups, which is unfortunate in some ways, but I think these things are also needed to get people speaking up who would have not spoken up. I mean, everything from, you know, political scumbaggery and all the stupidity there, and Confederate flags and Black Lives Matter and you know, anything and everything that people make a kerfuffle out of, you know, to DeviantArt doing this and so on and so forth. It's all inspired people who don't normally speak up to speak up. So the silent majority is starting to get a little less silent. So it's a shame it takes all these different kicks in the ass, but it is nice to see. So I'm going to...
Speaking as soon as I posted that journal, I've already gotten two comments, and one favorite, one from that guy who said thanks for featuring my meme, and then the other guy, essentially Mick Spider, commented on the why Core has got to go, and he said, I was starting to build up the points I needed to buy the original premium membership, and it goes to Core, and I give up because of the price increase. It has indeed gone full-blown retard. And then, of course, Commander Dominic says, thanks for featuring my meme. But, DA is gonna get everything they have coming to them. I wouldn't be surprised if they get lawsuits over this whole thing. You know, just because DA is essentially holding all of its premium members at gunpoint, saying, you know, oh, well, you can just pay more because, you know, well, just because if you can afford that, then you must be able to afford this, or whatever their dumb logic is. But anyway, moving on back to the original comment that we're reading. Onto something that needed to be done, which was greatly ignored, communication to the community. There's no reason whatsoever for this to have been announced over 3 weeks after Core's launch. None, no excuses. You must have seen the extreme backlash of the community. You should have had something immediately ready, at least a brief rundown, something to give us info on what was going on, not stay quiet and hope we figure it out on our own. I don't want to say this, but this kind of incompetence is just unreal. I can understand a couple of hours to even as much as 3 days for it to get out, but not three plus weeks. You let the community rip your reputations from you by neglecting the info you needed to give us immediately. People have boycotted Core, quit DeviantArt to go elsewhere. You've driven members away by doing this. In short summary, just change the icon color to the shade of green the naming has turned people away from core in general, making it seem like it's nothing more than a slight tool to get rid of ads, which is the best thing you list that it does. Give us the whole rundown of things it gives us, not a few petty things. A large number of us cannot afford the new prices, so in the end, you're getting no more money than before. Since most of us who could barely afford premium will not be continuing the payments, give us a choice of rebilling, not shove it down our throats for communication just to get the info to us. Something telling us what's going on, end of story, keep us in the loop. If anything I've said is wrong, then by all means correct it. I don't like having false info, and most of the info I have was gathered through the community itself. I care for this site and I want to continue existing, but from how things seem to be going, I'm afraid it may not be around for too many more years to come. And it hurts me to say that. Yeah, I mean, DA is probably one of the best sites I think ever created on the internet. You know, I've done more on DA than I ever thought was possible. You know, DA changed my total perceptions on the internet. I mean, you know, just the people I've met here, like you, or, you know, my ex-girlfriend, or, you know, any number of people that I've met here, you know, just changed my perceptions on life, reality, and, you know, have opened up doors to opportunities that I never thought were possible nor available, you know. And now we've got a bunch of incompetent fuckpards up in the DA staff who are just basically tearing that all apart and ripping it to shreds like it's no big deal. And as the old biblical quote goes, I hope they reap what they sow, because what they're doing is totally unforgivable. And then there's my journal there, which is just a copy of Dave's journal. Thank you for the favorite. Hold on, I'm just going to your journal so that way I can add it onto mine. Okay, going to thumb, copy, going back to my page. Edit. Okay, here we go. Update. And your journal is now featured there. or should be, hopefully, at least is on mine. Yep, there it is.
Okay, yeah. I think that's really all there is to say on that for now and for this video. I mean, we've been on this hangout for a while, and I think we went into a lot of detail about the situation. And of course, I'll be making a little, my usual graphic for, you know, every time I do a PSEC video, I make a graphic that represents it, and that'll be up on DeviantArt, and it'll, you know, go back to this video and so on, and people can, feel free to add their comments about it on YouTube, on DA, you know, wherever, whatever. So, yeah, both on DeviantArt and YouTube and beyond, there's going to be opportunities for people to comment on this video and add their two cents and whatever. So, yeah, interesting shit. We'll see how this goes.
Mm-hmm.
And anything else to add before I close out?
No, nothing really. I mean, just kind of more of what I've already said. You know, we're living in interesting times, and, you know, there's just a lot of really interesting stuff going on right now in the world stage. I mean, DA is just a smaller example of, you know, what's going on in physical real-time reality. And it's just, it is what it is, you know. We just got to band together and stand against it and, you know, use our voices. We are powerful, you know, by speaking out, you know, because change isn't going to come from being complacent and just waiting for people to babysit us and, you know, something better. We've got to chase after that under our own, you know, out of our own will, out of our own, you know, desire. We can't just wait for other people to do it for us, you know. It's like George Washington said, we won the revolution, we fought for your freedom, now it's your job to keep it, you know. Yeah. It's never a constant task, it's not something that's just handed to you, and it's like, okay, now you've always got it, and it's always there, and it's just something you can abuse and take for granted.
Yeah, totally.
So, you know, all I can say to people out there that are watching and listening, you know, just stay vigilant, use critical thinking and discernment, and, you know, stand up for yourself, stand up for your family, stand up for your friends, everybody you know and care about, even strangers. You know, if you see something wrong, call it out for what it is. Don't be afraid to use your voice.
Point out the elephant in the room.
Mm-hmm.
And respect people's rights to hate you for it, because believe me, a lot of people will.
Mm-hmm. But anyway,
so guess that's it.
Mm-hmm.
Catch everybody in a few hours, actually, when we have that other person with a name that's difficult to pronounce on here. And yeah, some more fun DeviantArt conversation coming up in a few hours. So see you then.